In this video today, I want to walk you through how to publish pilot studies and studies that had a lot of negative results in them really easily. So I know a lot of us are scared to publish them or aren't really sure how to go about doing that. So today I'm going to walk you through, and I've done this twice now, so I'm going to show you some of the things that I did in those studies as well. If you don't know me, I am Dr. Lana Reister. I have my PhD in chemistry, and on this channel I make content to help graduate students and researchers thrive in their research and spend more of their time doing what they truly love. One of the biggest things that comes in whenever you're talking about going to graduate school or being a researcher is obviously publishing. And one of the things that we really struggle with is, okay, what if my study doesn't give me the results I want? Or what if I try and do this pilot study and then I can't publish it later? So today I want to walk you through to, if you're just getting started in your research, take away some of those fears. And if you have a study that has a lot of negative results or is a pilot study, doesn't necessarily maybe have all of its controls in place and things like that, I want to give you a path forward for how to actually go about publishing those results. So the very first step that you want to go through whenever you're looking to publish any kind of study, but especially a pilot study or one with negative results, is to find the story in your results or your research. This is what I talk about in every single writing video I do. It's such the important first step. And if you're struggling with this, I really suggest you download my scientific research paper checklist. It helps you start developing that story by starting with your data first. But when you have a pilot study, what I want you to think about is, what is the main thing you want someone to know from this data, right? Because even if it's a pilot study, even if you only had three results, you could have learned a very important piece of information that will inform future studies. And it's important to be able to share that, and it is publishable work. So what I challenge you to do is start with saying, what is the main thing they need to know? Whether it comes from negative results, so everyone in the world thinks that this gene results in, you know, this disease, and you ran a study and you found out that it didn't. Well, that's a very, very publishable study, because everyone else who's going to try and pursue this angle needs to learn that at least the way that you measured it, it didn't make a difference. So that should be like your main conclusion, is that this does not directly affect this, at least within this population, right? And if you're doing a pilot study and you found something super cool, but maybe you don't have as many samples as you really should have to say that this is, you know, very true in the broader population, you can still publish that this thing is true within the context of your study. So that's what I want you to start with. What is the main conclusion you want people to have? And then work back on how you create the story that supports that final main conclusion. For example, in one of my pilot research papers, we created a method that allowed us to analyze corticosterone and lipids together. And we were able to do this quantitatively and everything like that. But we didn't have the time or the resources to be able to go through all of the validation steps to fully validate this method that's typically required for a lot of method development papers. But we still thought what we did was really important for the field that might want to be able to do that later on. So I published a paper on this. And what was the main story? The main story was that I was able to take a very small volume of serum, extract out and do a qualitative analysis on lipids and a quantitative analysis on the steroid. So then from there, what's my story? Well, my story is, here's my method development process. Here's what the final thing that I came to. And then what's the next step? I need to show them that steroids and lipids were analyzed in a single run, okay? Next part of my story, okay, now that steroids and lipids are analyzed in a single run, my second part is, can we qualitatively identify lipids? Okay, check, got that. So then the third part of my story is, can we quantitatively measure corticosterone? So from there, I was able to show them in really pilot data that we were able to measure corticosterone, the levels were reasonable for what we were expecting and that we were able to do it reproducibly. Now, what I didn't do is say, okay, this is the method we got, or this is the concentration we got from this, and this is the concentration we got from how it's typically performed, you know, in animal science. We didn't have the resources to be able to do that, but the story was still there, right? And so if you can create out that story, whether it's with negative results, whether it's with a small number of samples, if you can create out that story, that's going to be the number one thing that results in whether you're actually going to get accepted and published. So from your story, you really want to think about the second thing is, how are you contributing to your field? What is the significance? Why should this be published? This is the next thing that you need to really have down, because you're going to put it in the cover letter for your paper to the editor of the journal you're submitting it to. So you want to make sure that you know exactly why this deserves to be published. Why does everyone in your field need to know about this work that you're doing here? So in the example I had earlier, where I was creating a method and trying to get it published, the contribution, why people needed to know, is they need to know that there was a different way to analyze this. You know, it may not be a validated method, but you can actually shorten your run, shorten your prep, all of these things, by analyzing your steroids with your lipids instead of doing specific steroid analysis and specific lipid analysis. And so that is what I'm putting out there. That's whenever I wanted to get this published, that's what I'm stating. Like, this is the fundamental novelty and the significance of this paper. So even though it hasn't gone through as much work as a full study would have done, you know, this still deserves to be published. And so once you have that statement down, write it down and have it ready to go. You're going to put it in your introduction, you're going to put it in your conclusion, and you're going to put it in your cover letter for your paper. The third thing that I want you to think about is the medium that you're going to publish in. So a lot of people know about how to publish regular research articles. And sometimes whenever you have a pilot study or a study with a lot of negative results, it can be a lot more difficult to publish a regular research article. So a different form that's really meant for your pilot studies, really meant for things like that, is communications. And so not every journal is going to have communications, but if you can find a journal that is already on your list for a good fit for this, what I suggest you do is look at their author guidelines and look to see if they have a form of communication or short article, is another thing it can be called, that basically is meant to highlight really innovative things that aren't substantive enough for a full or regular research article. So the study that I've been talking to you about, I published as a communication. This allowed me to not have to do all the additional validation work because it was really novel. It was really important to get out there, and it still needed to be built upon. And that's really what that communication is meant for. So look into the journals that you want to publish in and see if they have communications as an option. And I highly suggest, if you're nervous about the amount of work, about the number of samples, or things like that, look into publishing it as a communication first. My fourth and final tip is, whenever you are working with a pilot study, you want to make sure that you are appropriately communicating your results, the impact of the results, and the limitations of the results. So what I see a lot of people fail at whenever they are doing a study is they want to over communicate. This is the best thing in the world. There's no limitations here. Don't, you know, look too closely at what we're doing. And they over generalize to the population. Like, maybe they have an N of three, they found something really cool, and instead of saying, you know, this is an avenue for further research, they write the paper like that is a substantial fact. And that will a lot of times get you, you know, rejected from papers, because someone reads this and go, you have an N of three. Like, you can't make these claims. This should be automatically rejected. Where if you write it in, we found this is really cool and we think this is a great further avenue of investigation, that is more likely to be able to get you accepted, because you're not making wild, outlandish claims. especially if you're clearly acknowledging the limitations of your study. I think that is a number one thing that will, you know, kind of soften reviewers whenever they're going through it. And I've even submitted papers and literally one of the biggest reviews was, you need to address these five limitations for me to be able to, you know, accept this paper. And so thinking about what are the limitations of your study and putting it out there, you know, writing it in the paper itself is going to really help you in being able to actually publish that paper. If you are looking to write your first paper, make sure that you download my free scientific research paper checklist. It's a checklist that basically walks you step by step through how to write every single section of your paper and submit it and everything. So you can download that. It's completely free. The link will be in the description below. And I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.